Do you want to report on the loading time of your website in GA4, Google Analytics 4? Have you been looking for page load time metrics but can't find them? Well, you're in the right place. In this video, I'm going to show you exactly how to set up and report on the loading time of your pages. Okay, if you've been looking through your reports and are stuck because you can't find any loading time metrics, you're not missing anything. It's not that they're hidden, it's that these metrics aren't available in GA4. I'm guessing they will be added to our reports at some point, but in the meantime, the only option is to set up page load time tracking ourselves, and I'm going to show you how to do this using Google Tag Manager. So let's head to GTM. I've opened the GTM container that is installed on my website. If you're already using GTM, then I'm guessing you already have GA4 implemented, but let's quickly check this by navigating to Tags. We can see there is a GA4 configuration tag. You'll need this in your container too. If you're just getting started with Google Tag Manager and you don't see a GA4 configuration tag in your container, then take a moment to watch my Google Tag Manager tutorial. I've included a link in the description below this video. And if you already have a GA4 configuration tag, you're ready to go to the next step. So let's navigate to Variables. And let's create a new user-defined variable. Let's name the variable page load time. Let's select variable configuration and choose custom JavaScript as the variable type. Now let's head to my blog. Here we can see the custom JavaScript we'll use to calculate our page's loading time. I've included a link to the post in the description below this video. Let's copy the code. This uses the Performance Navigation Timing API and calculates the amount of time in milliseconds between load event end and start time, which gives us the page load time. We then take the number of milliseconds and convert them to seconds. And here's a quick tip. If you wanted to report on milliseconds instead of seconds, you could adjust the JavaScript. This would provide more granular reporting in Google Analytics. Now let's head back to Google Tag Manager and paste the JavaScript code. Now let's select Format Value, enable the option Convert Undefined To, and let's enter 0 as the value. This will mean if the Navigation Timing API fails, then the variable will return a value of 0. Now let's save the variable. The next step is to create a trigger to fire a tag for our page load event. So let's navigate to Triggers. Let's click New to create a new trigger. Let's name the trigger Page Loaded. And let's select Trigger Configuration. Now let's select Page View Window Loaded as the trigger type. This trigger will fire our tag after a page has completely loaded in the browser. Let's save the trigger. And let's create another trigger. Let's name the trigger Page Load Time Less Than 0. Let's select Trigger Configuration and choose Custom Event as the trigger type. Now let's enter full stop asterisk as the event name and then enable the option to use regular expression matching. Now let's select the option for the trigger to fire on some custom events. And using the drop-down, let's ensure page load time is selected. Then let's choose less than and enter 0. We're going to use this trigger to prevent our tag from firing if our custom JavaScript variable returns a value less than 0. Now let's save the trigger. The next step is to create a GA4 event tag to send the loading time of our pages to Google Analytics. So let's navigate to Tags. And let's create a new tag. Let's name the tag Google Analytics GA4 Page Load Time. And let's select Tag Configuration. And let's choose GA4 Event as the tag type. Now we need to select our GA4 Configuration tag using the dropdown. I mentioned this at the start of the video, but again, if you're just getting started with GTM, then you can watch my full GTM tutorial to learn more about setting this up. Okay, now let's name our event page_load_time. Now we need to select event parameters, and let's add a row. Now let's name the parameter loading_time_sec. And for the value, let's select our page load time variable. Now we need to select triggering. And let's select the page loaded trigger we just created. Then under exceptions, we need to add our other trigger. Let's select the page load time <0> trigger. This will prevent the tag from firing if the page load time variable has a value <0. Now let's save the tag. And let's click Preview. Enter our URL. And click Connect. Our website loads and it's connected to Tag Assistant. Now let's select the Tag Assistant tab. And let's select the window loaded event on the left. We can see our page load time event has been fired. And we can see the amount of time the page took to load. Once you're happy everything is working correctly, it's time to head back to GTM. And let's publish the changes. The loading time of our pages are now being sent to Google Analytics. Okay, the next thing we need to do is register our loading time parameter in GA4. To do this, let's head to Google Analytics. Let's navigate to Admin. Then select Custom Definitions in the Property column. And let's select Custom Metrics. And then create custom metrics. Let's name the metric page load time. Enter loading_time_sec as the event parameter. And select seconds as the unit of measurement. Now let's save our custom metric. Moving forward, you'll be able to use the metric in your reports. Now that we're sending loading time to GA4, the next step is to report on the performance of our pages. We can do this by creating an exploration report, but I'll show you how you can create a more actionable report in Looker Studio, which was previously called Google Data Studio. Let's start by heading back to Google Analytics. Let's start by navigating to Explore. And let's create a new blank report. Let's give our report a name. And now we need to add the dimensions and metrics we want to use. Let's start by adding a dimension. I'm going to add the page path and screen class dimension to my report, but you can use any of the page-based dimensions you like. For example, you could also use page location, page title, or landing page as the dimension. Now let's click Import. Next, we need to add metrics. I'm going to add the views metric and our custom page loading time metric. Now we can add the dimension and metrics as rows and values. This lets us see the loading time for the pages on our website. However, as we can see, it presents the total loading time for each page combined. I'm expecting that Google will let us present averages for our custom metrics in the future, but currently we need to either export our data or use Looker Studio. My preference is Looker Studio, so let's take a look at the steps to view the average loading time using the data we've collected. Let's head to Looker Studio. First, we need to create a report and connect our GA4 property to Looker Studio. So let's create a new report. And let's add our GA4 property as the data source. Now let's adjust the table. I'm going to add the page path dimension. But again, you can add your preferred page-based dimension. Now let's adjust the metrics in the table. Let's add event count. And average page loading time. The average page loading time metric is automatically created in Looker Studio for us, so that's why I've added this metric. However, you can also use the page loading time metric, which is what we added to our exploration report. Finally, we need to add a filter to our chart because there might be cases where a page view has been collected without our page load time tag firing. For example, if you decided to adjust the trigger so the event doesn't fire on every page, if there was an error or if the page loading time was calculated as 0 seconds or less. So let's add a filter. Let's name the filter. And let's ensure include is selected. Then we choose event name. Then equal to, and enter page_load_time. This ensures we're only including pages where the page load time event was triggered in the table. We can now see the average loading times for the pages on our website. Here's a tip. Looker Studio automatically displays the loading time metric in the hours, minutes, and seconds format. If you prefer to see this reported as a number, you can click the edit icon, the small pencil icon, next to the metric. Then change the type from duration to number. I find this makes it easier to read and interpret the average page loading times in the report. Now that you're tracking page load time in GA4, you can report on the performance of your content. I recommend using the report we created to identify pages with lots of views that are also slower to load. You can then optimize those pages to decrease their loading time. This will improve performance and can lead to more conversions on your website. If you want to learn even more about Google Analytics 4, then take a moment to subscribe to this channel. Every week I release new tutorials covering Google Analytics and Google Tag Manager to help you boost your skills. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.